To perfect the saints. Keep going.
If my people who are called by my name.
Stop right there. Here's the antidote for all that will come at you in life. Newsflash, you want to write this down. Come on. This is where the power comes in. Yes, you just saw all the bad stuff that was coming. We saw what? The heavens are shut up. Is that bad?
Yes.
Don't you hate when you feel like you can't even get past God?
Yes.
Get past the ceiling when you're trying to talk to God?
That's right.
I know I do.
Yeah.
So there's no rain or command. The Lord. See, rain means rain in the Old Testament represents blessing.
Yeah.
Because they were in a Gregorian society, understood that crops couldn't grow if there was no rain. Don't you hate when you walk in life and it feels like no blessings are coming your way?
Yes.
And you feel like you're seeing everybody get blessed but yourself?
Come on.
Heavens have been shut up. Why? Because God's trying to get your attention.
Yes.
Trying to get your attention. Command the locusts to devour the land or send pestilence. Just allow the enemy to steal, kill, and destroy in certain things in your life.
Circumstances
are all around you. Whole essence coming out here pretty big and you're pretty outfit. Praise God. You can be the example. If I can represent, she's going to represent the believer that's you're not there yet. And all the circumstances are coming all around you. She tried to go to the right, tried to go to the left. Circumstances there. Try to go front. Circumstances there. Try to go to the left. Circumstances there. It's all around you.
Mm-hmm.
It's overtaking you. But all you got to do is surrender. Amen?
Yes.
14th verse. If my people, who are what? Called by my name, would puff themselves up.
Humble themselves.
And what? Pray.
Yes.
And seek my face. Yes. That's a process. You can't go to prayer before you humble yourself.
Amen.
It's not about America. We don't want to have to humble ourselves. Mm-hmm. Now, can I say it like the old folk used to say in the church when I was growing up? They said, you got to be, they wouldn't use the age. They said, you got to be humble.
Yeah.
I mean, I heard that before.
Yeah.
I hear one of the mothers at my church talking. She would get up in a testimony, and she talked about the trials that she was going through, but then how God gave her the victory. She said, all you young folks, I want y'all to know, you gotta be humble to get close to God.
Yes.
And when you see humble, they said, humble. Are you humble? If you just said yes, you ain't humble.
Come on.
Give you a trick question. Because if you're humble, you don't know it. Because you try to get more humbler. I don't even know if that's a word, but they can say it. If my people are called by my name, would humble themselves and pray and seek my face. Humble themselves. Pray. Prayers. Communicate with God. Lord, help me. I surrender. And what? Seek my face. His face represents his understanding. Get into God's word. God, I want to understand what you're doing.
Yes.
Not so much the why, but what? What are you doing on inside of me? What are you trying to teach me? Because I'm telling you, in the midst of every trial, in the midst of every process, there is a lesson.
Yes.
You don't just put flour and water and butter and throw it in the oven just for the sake of putting it in the oven. You put it in the oven so that a cake can rise out of that thing and you can eat some cake someday.
Yes.
If you feel like you're writing God's up and you're being stirred up and masked up and pressed up and you're being placed in the fire, God's trying to make something out of your life so someone can eat from it one day.
Yes.
Just stop there. It says, then what? Turn from their wicked ways. Mm-hmm. Turn. It means you got to walk away from the mess.
Mm-hmm.
Forget the mess. Keep the press and reach for the best. Then will I hear from heaven and I will forgive their sins and heal their land. Let's keep going. Four instruments of the process of God. Let me tell you the first way the process comes. Are you ready for this? It says, number one, from my own doing. How many know we can do some stupid stuff?
Yes.
How many know we can make some stupid decisions? God tells us to go left. No, I just want to go right. Why you want to do that? Well, I know it's not the word of God. I know I shouldn't do this without getting my spouse permission, but I'm just going to do it. Because I'm the boss. No, I said spouse. I didn't say husband or wife. I said spouse.
Yes.
God wants you to be in you. I'm just going to do it because, you know, I heard from God. How many of them tell you so? Every word from God can be tested.
Yes. Amen.
But I just felt. I just felt like I was supposed to do this. Knowing you have a bad habit of doing that thing, and you have gonna keep feeling like that until you allow God to change. Are y'all with me?
Yes, come on.
From my own doing. You got anything to add to that speech? Yes. From my own doing. What is some of the dumb stuff we do?
Ignore what God has already told us to do.
Come on,
and so
talk
you
about
can get it by revelation or by tribulation. That's one of my favorite reminders to myself. If God is telling me to obey in a certain area and I refuse to, then there's going to be consequences. So that's why, you know,
well, you said that bad word. There's going to be what?
Consequences.
You mean there's going to be something to pay for my disobedience?
Yes. Going back to the laws, if I jump off this building, gravity will work. I will fall, and I'll probably break some bones. Just like if I don't tithe off my first fruit, then I will have lack. Because he says he rebukes the devourer for my sake when I give of my first fruit.
Yes.
So those are just examples of how we can do that. So Hosea 4 and 6 from the Message Bible says, my people are ruined because they don't know what's right or true. Because you turn your back on knowledge. I turn my back on you, priest. Because you refuse to recognize the revelation of God, I'm no longer recognizing your children.
This is what God says to his church. The priest of the believer. Who's the priest of the believers in the New Testament? We are.
We are. Chosen generation.
Proverbs 19, 2 and 3. Message Bible. Read that, Speedy Jakes.
Ignorant zeal is worthless. Haste makes waste. People ruin their lives.
Who ruin their lives?
People.
Who ruins it?
People. Ruin their lives by their own stupidity. So why does God always get blamed?
People ruin their lives by their own stupidity. Then they want to blame God. We've been preaching get out of debt. How long have we been preaching get out of debt? Since we started this ministry.
Yes, years. Yes.
8 years. 8 for new beginning. But you still want to get that credit card and run and get into debt.
That's true.
And you wonder why you're struggling.
Amen.
Amen.
God don't want you to use plastic to bless folks if you can't pay the bill.
That's true.
Did you hear me, church?
Amen. Amen.
Well, I just thought I'd be a blessing. Well, no. God appreciates your intentions, but he wants you to do it his way.
Mm.
Are you with me, church?
Come on.
God don't want you spending money that you don't have. It's called stewardship.
Yeah.
Be faithful over that little. So instead of pulling that plastic out, why don't you just get the dollar? The dollar. Everybody say the dollar.
The dollar.
That's in your pocket.
Amen.
That you have, that you can feel.
Yes.
And say, baby, I know it ain't much, but just God bless you.
Yes.
Well, Pastor, $100 looks better. Not when you don't have it.
Living within your means.
That dollar, you know what? I've given people a dollar, see, no problem with a dollar. Then I've given people $100 of what I don't have, and they say they won't even appreciate it. Why? Because I'm supposed to give them that $100. Because they won't mind to give.
Amen.
But I feel good. Feel real proud about it. Walk ahead and give you $100. Give me $1,000, whatever. But it was the money that I had.
Very good.
You got to learn to live within your means.
Amen.
You got to learn to be humble.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And I really don't feel good because once I get that bill and I can't pay it, and if I see that person I gave the money to, they don't seem appreciative, I'm mad both ways. And I shouldn't be mad because I made a fool out of myself with my stupid decision. Amen.
And we call that tribulation, but really, if we had just obeyed the revelation,
come on,
we wouldn't be going through the tribulation of lack.
Amen.
Amen. Paying interest on something we shouldn't have given away in plastic. Amen.
Amen.
So Galatians 6:5 says, each of you must take responsibility for doing the creative best you can with your own life.
You mean I'm actually responsible for my decisions?
Right. Yes.
The Word of God says that?
Yes.
Yes.
Amen. You mean I can't blame my parents? I can't blame their mistakes and what they did because I have to answer to God. Boy, it's quiet in this Presbyterian church.
Very good one.
Reach. I can't blame my spouse.
Reach.
Come on.
Ah, you are responsible for your own actions. You're going to have to, let's make it straight. You're going to have to appear before God one day, and your mom and dad ain't going to be there.
Amen.
Your spouse is going to be you and God.
Yes.
And you're going to, man, some of you used to run so much game. Some of you will lie to the most holiest people you know because there's no fear of God in your life. But I'm telling you, when God looks at you with his eyes of holiness, and he looks through you, see, the Holy Spirit, how many ever felt the presence of God? I don't know about you, but I feel the presence of God. I can't even talk.
Mm-hmm.
I was praying for some of you down there, and I felt the presence of God. All I could do is go in tongues. I couldn't even talk.